friends. Today it's a very special video because today I am going to take you through a pen which it's something really out of the world. The pen, the way it writes, I've never seen, I've never heard, or I've never experienced any neb write so brilliantly as the Pilot Custom Urushi. So this is Pilot Custom Urushi. It's this one is a all black. You do get a vermilion one, this is a all black, and here how it goes. The pen comes in this simple, unassuming cardboard box. This is the outer white sleeve. Then you have this cardboard box. As you take the hood off, you'll see this inner box. The front, the one edge of the box can be easily put down, so the this particular pen case can be grabbed easily. A nice thinking, by the way. Very simple. There's nothing embossed over it. Just a clear black case, and here you see Pilot written at the back, and that's all. Pen, well, it's out there. So this is a simple ribbon underneath, which you see the elastic band and a very soft kind of a base which can be taken up, and then you have this cardboard, again inner inset, and then these are the cartridges and a bit of details on the Urushi and about the maintenance care guide. So there you have, put it aside and then come to the pen. So I'll just take everything apart away from the scene. Well, here is the pen. This is a big pen. This is a big pen, and it's a brilliant pen. It's beautiful. The nib is beautiful, and when you start writing with it, I don't think you'd like anything better than this particular writing experience, as is with this Custom Urushi. The pen, before I even start writing with this, I think it would be wise to just put things into perspective by making a comparison. So here you have a Pilot Custom Urushi, and you place it alongside one of another bigger pens which I know, which is a Pelican 1000, and you see how it dwarfs a Pelican 1000 M1000. This is a Montblanc 146, and to compare a Lamy 2000. So you see a comparison with a standard pen where it rates. It's a big pen, there's no telling that, but it's pretty light because the pen is made up of ebonite and it's been coated with this brilliant Urushi lacquer, which has been done by hand, and it's got such a brilliant mirror finishing to it. The pen basically has multiple coats of Urushi lacquer over it, and it's been made over a very lengthy process with a very strict control of temperature and humidity levels. Otherwise it doesn't bring it out to this particular finish as it has got now. So coming to the pen per se, you have the cap and the finial. You see a kind of a round button shaped inner circle. I think this is something different than ebonite, I'm not sure, and you have a gold plated ring around this. Then you have a clip which is attached to this small ring here. The clip is a typical Pilot clip in a triangular fashion with Pilot stamped on the top upper part, and then you have a ball at the lower end. You find this kind of a clip on Pilot 823 as well as Pilot Custom 845, which I'm aware of. The pen clip is very functional, and the rounded bottom makes sure that you can pin it easily to your pockets. But I generally would like to to place this pen apart from anything than a pen sleeve, because the way it snaps back onto the cap, I think it'll probably crack this up a bit. I don't know, but I'm scared. So I won't like to put it in my pocket. Every time I remove it, it tends to snap back. So this may tend to crack up the lacquer here. Well, just a thought. The pen has this, the cap on the lower part has a small ring there, and then you have the thick band which says, this says Custom Urushi, and then 3 stars Pilot, made in Japan. Taper slightly onto the barrel. The barrel increases in girth a bit and then again tapers back to a flat bottom. This has a ring here. It's not a piston filler, it's a cartridge converter pen. So this is just for show purposes, and you have again a small rounded rounded kind of a button shaped appearance at the base. The pen opens up in just about quarter to two turns, and then here you go to witness a gorgeous nib. It's unlike anything I've seen. This is a brilliant nib. Not only the way it looks, the performance, you'll see in some time, it performs brilliantly. So while we are discussing the nib, it has a bit of stamping, Pilot, and then it mentions the size. This is a size 30 nib, and Pilot has their own, they have their own way of describing sizes, from 5, 10, and then they have 15, and then this one is the 30. I believe the number 15 is on Pilot 823. It's a two-tone nib. This is a broad, and it's a big nib. The writing section has small tapering and then flares up again. It seems as if the writing section is small, but if you couple the length of this nib with the writing section, I don't think you would want to hold this pen anything but here. Because this is a very good distance from the paper when you're writing. You won't like to hold the pen anywhere but on this section itself. A small band here, then threads which are not at all very prominent and just don't come in the way at all. And then the barrel opens up, which reveals a very good thought of strategy of having a Con 70 converter on this. It's pre-fitted on this. Because the big feed, the big size of the nib, the way it lays down the line, it will soon dry up if there is anything but this converter. The metal section ensures that you can't have it in an eyedropper fashion. I don't think you would even consider that. Well, so that's about the pen. Can't take my eyes off this finish. But then the main thing, how this pen works. Well, here we go. So I have this small book which I have just got bound for the purpose, and these are simple A4 size papers, photocopy papers, and let's see. So this is a Pilot. Custom Urushi. It's a broad nib. I'm fond of broad nib on a Pilot because the way these Japanese pen write on slightly thinner part, the medium would be a bit on the finer aspect for me. Just to mention again that this is a 18 karat nib, and it also mentions on top of the nib, you can see it written 750. And it is written 18K. That's there. So this is a broad nib, and it's a 18 karat gold. The ink here is Colorverse Andromeda. It's a very nice greenish teal color, and I really like this particular shade. even with the smoothest of the pens, there was some kind of a sound whenever I wrote. I don't think you could hear even a single thing out of this one. Well, there are no adjectives to describe how this pen writes. It's a brilliant writer. The wetness of this pen is simply perfect. Because there's a broad nib, it lays down a very saturated line, and as the nib starts getting broader and broader, and the size goes on increasing, you would find that the downstrokes and the horizontal strokes, there's a slight difference, because obviously there's a bit of flex to them when you bring them down, which is not there when you glide them across. So the tines open up and it lays a slightly thicker line on the downward stroke. I have to change my visual analog scale for wetness, because I have to really pinpoint where this stands. To increase the length of this, these pens are so brilliant, and the way it writes, I don't think if it would write a bit more wet than this, then you would start seeing a lot of feathering and bleed through with this kind of a nib and this kind of a line which it puts, and it's immensely smooth. There's almost just enough friction for it to lay down the line, but you won't even feel the way it glides across the paper. It's simply mind-blowing. There was one issue which I had with the pen, which I don't think is it's showing up now. On fast downwriting, you see that there's a bit of railroading here. I had this issue with the King of Pen, which I then sent back for servicing, and it's back in Japan now. Probably they are changing the feed or the section, I don't know what they're doing with it. But this is the issue which I had with the pen. On very quick downstrokes while I'm putting my signatures, this probably the ink can't, the feed can't keep up with the demand of the nib. But if the speed of writing is a bit slow on the downward strokes, you probably won't find that particular issue coming up again. Just the posting part, I didn't bring up that because, and the reverse writing. I think you can reverse write with this. It writes on a pretty fine side. Flex I won't, but just about a single stroke, you can get a good line variation out of this. But these nibs, they do flex, but would you like to? It's a pretty costly pen, so I don't think these nibs are to be tried and flexed. Well, here I come up with the end of this review. One of the best pens that I've come across and the best writers that I've seen, Custom Urushi. I hope you like this video. Keep writing and take care.